Everyone has a favorite Disney movie from their childhood. You know, you go Little Mermaid or Beauty and the Beast, whatever it may be. Disney has been shelling out these reboots the last couple years, and it pretty much makes it a guarantee that whatever your favorite movie was that you hold dear to your heart at some point is going to be completely ruined for a cash grab. So James, in a perfect world, how could we fix these live-action remakes?
So it's tough, because I know Disney's like committed to this live-action BS.
But got a good dozen movies on the way in the next couple years.
We gotta ditch this, man. Like, and some of them maybe make sense because you have these, you know, these human characters, and maybe if it's all like Hercules or something like that, what the hell does live action Lion King actually mean? Let's think about this. Let's put our thinking caps on as society for 1 second, and let's like think about this. Like, on paper, what does that even mean? You're not gonna get real animals to act this out. So it's an animated movie. This is an animated movie.
The movie is 100% animated.
This is an animated movie. So first of all, cut the bullshit, all right? Some of these movies are not, it just doesn't translate. And on top of that, I think a lot of these movies, people are saying if you just reanimate, you know, these same stories, like it'll just be a regurgitation, the same movie. Take some notes from Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. The way that they used animation to make a refreshing, cool movie in a, you call superhero movies monotonous, or you call them like, we're getting the same thing every single time. What a refreshing new take. And if you're Disney and you have billions of dollars, an absolute empire, basically Amazon, you have all those resources, I'm not going to give you any passes to not mix things up.
I think this is what happened in the writer's room, hopefully. If you make like a Spider-Verse-esque, like a really well animated Lion King like adaptation, like it could have been really cool. It could have done a cornerstone club with the musical numbers, like it could have been great. But they were like, we can't just make another animated movie. Like, why won't anyone care? We have to make it like they're real animals. And so they make it with, these are real lions and real pigs and real whatever. And if you're a child watching that movie, like, those animals can't emote. They can't, like, produce emotions on their face. So how are you even following the movie? If you're just watching, like, a nature documentary with the Lion King soundtrack in the background, like...
Yes.
And so I'll move into, like, a movie like Beauty and the Beast. That was like one of the first ones that came out. I didn't love the movie, but I think it was appropriate because Beauty and the Beast is such an old movie, and you bring in like, you know, Emma Watson does a great job, and watching the clocks and stuff dance around, like it could have been better, but it could have been worse. Like I didn't hate that.
Yeah.
But on the other side of the spectrum, a movie like Aladdin. Aladdin is a great movie, and to bring in not only like to try and make a live action genie out of Will Smith that was just like disturbing to watch, like I don't know how kids didn't run out in fear, like, and not only due to that, but to replace Robin Williams with Will Smith. Will Smith is great, but he's not Robin Williams. No one is Robin Williams.
Not even close.
And that was like so much of the charm of that movie. The parts of it that were like in like Arabian Nights, like they were doing the dances and they had that like the accurate costumes, I thought like that's why you make it live action. Mm-hmm. But to the animated parts with the genie and with the magic, I don't think it works. It didn't work when I watched the movie, and that's what I'm worried about. For all the ones that are coming up, like The Little Mermaid, like, is The Little Mermaid all underwater gonna look like a fun movie if, like, she
we'll
gets
see.
Her...
We'll
yeah,
see.
like...
Well, like Little Mermaid, like Aladdin, I think an important thing is one, you gotta keep the songs. I think if you really want to retell these stories and do them their justice, everyone knows the songs are just such an integral part of why these are enjoyable, and there's a way to do it in which, like, you keep it, and people just have to be talented. Like, if you want to make a live action, you want to keep the song, sure. But then you gotta, you know, you gotta cast the right people, and it starts from there. But it's the in between, the plot. I think we can tinker just a little bit. Come on, like the way that they redid the Grinch a couple years ago, and they had the Grinch be more kind of like funny. He was like stress eating at one point. He was just like a human, and like. That was fun. I thought it was great. And yeah, it wasn't exactly the Grinch script, like, you know, bar for bar, line for line. But you know what? No one cared because it was still good.
I think that, like, Mulan and The Lion King are on opposite ends of the spectrum. I didn't see Mulan, but, like, they took out Mushu. They took out all the songs. They made it this very serious thing. And people are like, I loved Mulan, and you made it worse, and so I hate you for it. The Lion King, like, they just made the same movie again. So you're like...
You think it's a lose-lose.
It's a lose-lose because you're either... messing with something people love, or you're just regurgitating it the exact same thing. Mm-hmm. And there's a ton of movies that are coming out in the next couple years. Like Cruella, there's the 101 Dalmatians. Like, do we need a 101 Dalmatians villain origin story?
It would be really funny if it was like the Joker movie, but Cruella the villain, she's like slowly going insane. She's like, I used to think dogs were cute.
Just a dark, depressing, like, I'm gonna abuse puppies movie.
It's going crazy.
But to give them some credit, like, they're gonna remake Peter Pan. There have been some live action Peter Pans, but the one, the animated one that like I loved as a child, is not really okay to watch or celebrate nowadays with the stuff that is in that movie with Native Americans. So I'm like all on board. I think a live action Peter Pan totally can work. You can change up the story, you make some songs. I think a movie like that is perfect. A movie like Aladdin, a movie like 101 Dalmatians, they're gonna have live action Dalmatians talking to each other. I just don't see why it's necessary, why you would want it. I used to think for a long time that I heard a couple years ago that Walt Disney had in his will, like his dying wish, was that his creations would be remade for each generation in like the new updated technology. So I was like on board for these in spirit. Found out today.
It's fake news.
It's fake news. It was never true.
He did not want that. That was not. He didn't go into the chirogenic like chamber like Han Solo. Leia was like, "Do you want me to do the movies?" And he was like, "No, no."
That's the exact thing. It's not only is it not true. It's the opposite of true. When he made the Three Little Pigs in the 1930s, he made a ton of money. So they were like, "Keep giving us pigs. Give us more pigs." And he was like, "No, we're not going to just make the same thing." To quote, "You can't top pigs with pigs." You can't top pigs with pigs. You can't top lions with lions. No. You can't top genies with genies. Dalmatians with Dalmatians. None of the remakes are going to top the old ones. And so the only validation to make it is if you really think that it deserves a new story and you have a good plan for it. You're not just going to... They feel like cash grabs. It shouldn't feel like a cash grab when I walk into the stupid theater.
Yeah, no. And at the end of the day, the hard truth is that we're not going to be able to make any of these changes. So we're probably just going to accept that they're going to be horrible.